communication and planning.
It is extremely critical for the teacher with visually impaired and the classroom teacher to talk to one another. And given the reality of the classroom, very often the teacher is maybe only keeping one day ahead of her students, especially a new teacher. And very often the teacher with visually impaired has a fairly large caseload of students at many schools. In addition, you know, they might see the student for only part of a day or an hour a day or a few times a week or once a week. So being able to communicate about what the science curriculum is and what's expected in terms of models is really helpful.
An illustration of a diode connected to a battery is shown, alongside a similar three-dimensional tactile diagram constructed from toothpicks and wax strings.
Given a little warning, a teacher with visually impaired can create models or tactile diagrams for the classroom teacher that will enable that student to do whatever activity it is the other students are doing right along beside those students. Or in some cases, some pre-teaching might be necessary. And so if the teacher with visually impaired knows ahead of time what's expected and knows some of the concepts that this student with a visual impairment might not have, then the teacher of the visually impaired can do some pre-instruction that will help that student be more ready for whatever the concept is that's being introduced in the life sciences curriculum.